Welcome to the next session, the radiology in the diagnosis of tuberculosis. Next, we will discuss the radiological features in a pulmonary TB in comorbidities and pulmonary TB sequelae. Tuberculosis is the most common opportunistic infection affecting HIV zero positive patients and remains the most common cause of death in patients with HIV. HIV TB can occur in any stage of HIV, but radiological pattern of TB in HIV depends on the immune status of the patient and CD4 count. In a patients with early HIV, where CD4 count is more than 200, the radiological pattern usually occur a typical post primary pattern, and the infiltrates are usually in the upper lobe, apical and posterior segment. Cavitation is more common, and adenopathy and effusion are less common. In a patient with advanced HIV, where CD4 count is less than 200, the radiological features look like a atypical presentation of primary TB, and the infiltrates are seen more in the lower lobe and multiple sites, and they may have a miliary pattern. Cavitation are less common in advanced HIV, but adenopathy and effusion are more common in a advanced HIV. This X-ray showing tuberculosis in HIV, where the CD4 count are very high. So, there is a classical of a consolidation, it is airspace opacity involving the upper zone, that is apical and posterior segment, it is typical of a post primary, and there is also a cavity in the upper lobe. Here there is a tuberculosis in HIV, where the CD4 count are very low. This is a X-ray showing right paratracheal adenopathy. It is a similarly of a primary tuberculosis, and here there is a bilateral pleural effusion and also adenopathy. It is a typical of a radiological feature of a HIV TB in a low HIV of a low CD4 count. This X-ray shows tuberculosis in diabetes. Diabetes estimated to be cause 15% of present tuberculosis cases. Patients with diabetes have fourfold increased risk of developing TB. There is increased risk of failure or relapse or delayed sputum conversion. The radiological presentation of tuberculosis in diabetes usually involve a lower lung field. The patterns are different. The most important, they have cavitation. So, 80% of the cases have a cavitation in a lower lung field, and there will be nodule in 86% and exudative lesion in 22%. So, this is also a lower zone consolidation with a cavity. It is typical of a TB in diabetes. Tuberculosis in silicosis. Tuberculosis is 3 to 7 times higher in persons with silicosis. Radiological diagnosis of TB in silicosis is very difficult, because silicosis itself, there will be a nodules and masses. The radiological sign of TB in silicosis are when there is a rapidly developing soft tissue nodule or conglomerate mass nodule, or rapid changes in the radiological picture, or presence of cavity in the nodule, or opacity surrounding a pre-existing nodule, or development of pleural effusion and development of any middle lobe collapse because due to bronchial stenosis. All these things we can suspect tuberculosis in a silicosis. So, coming to PT sequelae, so sequelae can occur in both primary and post primary tuberculosis. Up to 40% of the patient with post primary, they have a marked fibrotic response which manifests as a atelectasis, retraction of the hilum, mediastinal shift to the fibrotic side and the compensatory emphysema. So, what is destroyed lung? So, destroyed lung, when you define destroyed lung, when more than 2/3 of the lung tissue has been replaced by the cavity or fibrosis, we call it as a destroyed lung. There is a complete destruction of the whole lung or major of part of the lung. So, it is occur in a primary, progressive primary TB and also post primary TB because of a secondary infections. So, this X-ray showing a large cavity, it's a destroyed lung. So, here is a destroyed lung, here there is a hilar enlargement, it is nothing but it is a dilated pulmonary artery, it is because of a sequelae of TB, because the patient is going for corpulmonale. So, bronchopulmonary fistula, it is due to establishment of spontaneous communication between bronchial tree and pleural space. The diagnosis is based on increasing amount of sputum production, multiple air cavity with air fluid level and shift of the mediastinum to the same side. CT can demonstrate site of the communication between the pleural space and the airway. So, here there is a multiple cavity with the fluid level, the shift of the mediastinum to the opposite side. This is a sequelae occurring in a post primary TB. Bronchiectasis. Bronchiectasis is a accepted universal sequelae of tuberculosis. It is seen in both primary and post primary tuberculosis. It is seen in 71% to 86% of the patients with the inactive disease. It is also sometimes seen in an active disease also, 30%. The bronchiectasis in TB is due to tuberculous bronchitis, or this is due to fibrosis with subsequent fibrosis or destruction of the and fibrosis of the lung parenchyma with a traction bronchiectasis. This X-ray shows a upper lobe bronchiectasis. It is usually seen in a pulmonary tuberculosis. There is a lower lobe, see, cystic bronchiectasis. Here it is a cylindrical bronchiectasis. These are all as usually seen in a primary TB. Here it is a, this is a post primary TB presenting with the bronchiectasis of the upper lobe. Aspergilloma, it is seen in 11% of patients with a chronic cavitary disease. It exists for many years without any symptoms. Hemoptysis is the more commonest symptom and is seen in 80% to 90% of the patient. Aspergilloma consists of a mass of fungal hyphae admixed with a mucus and cellular debris. So, radiologically it presents as a mass in a pre-existing cavity. There is a presence of a air crescent surround the mass. So, we call it as a radiological sign, we call it as a Monod sign. So, here it is also a presence of a aspergilloma in a pre-existing cavity. The complication is a hemoptysis. Next is a pleural thickening. So, in a pleural effusion due to post primary TB, the pleural effusions are infected. So, it present as a loculated effusion and there is a delay in healing, they form more of a pleural thickening or calcification. So, pleural thickening is seen in the visceral pleural layer. So, in a tuberculosis, thickening is seen in a visceral pleural layer, parietal pleura is rarely involved. So, this X-ray showing a fibrothorax, it is the most severe form of a pleural fibrosis. There is extensive damage to the visceral pleura the visceral pleura is completely thickened and there is a fusion of both visceral and parietal pleura, obliterating the pleural space. The mediastinum is shifted to the same side. There is a marked volume loss on the affected hemithorax and also reduced mobility of the lung. So, this is also a fibrothorax. There is a thickening of the both visceral and parietal pleura. Then these are the various parenchymal calcifications. So, it is a dystrophic calcification occurring in the damaged lung following a TB infection. It is a local organized process with local deposition of the crystalline hydroxyapatite calcium salt. So, these are all the calcifications. So, we can see the multiple parenchymal calcification. So, with this we conclude the radiological features in a TB comorbidities and PT sequelae. Thank you.